Good evening and welcome to the evening news for today, Monday, December 11, 2023. I am Jemima Holmes. Thank you for tuning in. Now let's take a look at some of the lead stories tonight. President Ali gets emotional as he reflects on intimate moments he shared with fallen heroes. Continue operations as usual, maintain confidence in economy. PSC urges businesses. Ali Maduro talks could help preserve regional peace, says Sir Sridhar Rampal. Salary increase cannot be viewed in isolation of other government measures, says Parag. And laborer remanded for murder over $5,000 bet. Now for the news in detail. It was an emotional moment on Sunday as President Dr. Irfan Ali paid tribute to the five soldiers who died whilst on service to the country, reflecting on the intimate moments he shared with the men and committing himself and his government to always standing by the families of those who have perished. He made the commitment whilst commissioning the Heroes Highway on the east bank of Demerara in their honor. Let's have a look.
Imagine Yong Khan, 35 years old, already serving our country for 19 years. 35 years old, already serving our country for 19 years. And if Shahood would speak about him, and however would speak about him, you would believe that he is Superman and Batman combined for real. He was on a mission to ensure he supervised a project to be completed by January so that we could more efficiently retool our troops on the border. This young man has made the ultimate sacrifice for our country. Retired Brigadier Beaton, on his retirement, said to me he's going into the sunset. Jenny would tell you, I said to him, which sunset? I said to him, turn to the sunrise, you have much more service to give. He said, thank you, sir, I'll talk to you in the morning. The next morning, I called him. He said, yes, sir, whatever you want. He sat on as a chair of the Ghana Defense, of the Ghana Sea Defense Board, and he went back to serve in the Ghana Defense Force. Because we took a decision that we are going to show the full skills of the Ghana Defense Force by implementing infrastructure projects all across our country. Brigadier Beaton was waiting for this highway to be completed. We had many conversations and shared many ideas. He has given his life for this country. He would have it no other way. For a matter of fact, he ensured he was on that flight that day because he wanted this airstrip to be completed. Jenny, the relatives of Brigadier Beaton, he lives on. He lives on in greater glory. His work would continue to live on. And the Ettering Bang airstrip, which is an important part of our defense, will stand testimony that he will live on. Shahood was a loyalist to the core. He was an outstanding individual. He could have gone the course of law. He could have done many more things that would earn him a lot of money, but he would want it no other way. Shahood would want it no other way. Welcome. A man of great integrity and character. Just completed his master's degree at the University of Ghana. Was so excited, full of life and energy. All he wanted to do. And in this mission, it was very special for him. He wanted to ensure that our reserves were in a place, our cadets, that they were in a place of readiness. That our recruitment, our training was in a state of readiness for what our country is faced with. And he did not want anyone to do it. He wanted to do it for himself. My Charles became my brother. My Charles is just not a military man. He allowed every Guyanese to see Guyana through the lens of my Charles. He saw himself as blessed with an opportunity to showcase his country. And that he did. Exceptionally. We spent many, many hours together, many days together. 2 weeks ago, Mike Charles was determined, in memory of a crash in the same area, to lower 2 wreaths for 2 pilots who died in that crash. He and Anson Weeks proceeded on one of their flights to the interior to make these wreaths with flowers. They flew over the site and they lowered those wreaths in honor of those 2 pilots. Is the selflessness. 50 years after a crash, the love was there and he went to do something in their honor. How many humans would do that? The chopper crew is very special to me. They might be the only person who know what my favorite flower is. And every time they go out, they would capture the image of those flowers and send it to me. I am clear in my mind that the Guyana Defense Force has one of the finest leadership in the entire region as it is right now. I'm clear in my mind as Commander-in-Chief that these men would buckle up and get down to business at the first call of defense for our country. Without a doubt, every Guyanese can go to sleep knowing that they will do it, because I know they will do it. Crawford and Jackson, our prayers are with you for your full recovery. We are thankful that God was good enough to give us back the 2 of you alive. We will stand by you, not in the short term, not in the medium term, but in the long term. You are part of the Guyana Defense Force family, and you will remain a part of the Guyana Defense Force family.
Serving as an extremely important road network, the new Eccles to Diamond Roadway was on Sunday commissioned and dedicated in honor of the 5 servicemen who died on a mission in defense of the country. Here are the details from Trishel Sobers.
The Heroes Highway was on Sunday commissioned in memory of the 5 Ghana Defense Force ranks who died in Wednesday's horrific helicopter crash. The GDF Bell 412 crashed about 9 miles southeast of Blake Slater's airstrip, Ikaruku Top, Kayuni River on Wednesday, resulting in the death of retired Brigadier Gary Beaton, Lieutenant Colonel Michael Shahood, Lieutenant Colonel Sean William, Lieutenant Colonel Michael Charles, and Sergeant Jason Kahn. Only 2 soldiers survived the crash, Corporal Dwayne Jackson and Lieutenant Andio Crawford, who are both receiving treatment at the Georgetown Public Hospital Corporation, GPHC. President Dr. Irfan Ali said that naming the highway in honor of these 5 fallen servicemen was appropriate and will continue to serve as a dedication site for all those in uniform who die in the line of duty going forward. The new 4-lane highway runs from Eccles to Diamond and features a roundabout at both ends.
This roundabout and the roundabout in Eccles are very important roundabouts. This roundabout would eventually connect the East Coast and Barbies to the East Bank and the West Bank, the West Coast and West Bank to the East Coast and Barbies. And all of this will connect Essequibo to Demerara and Barbies. Creating this single interlink between what is ours, our 3 counties, Essequibo, Demerara, and Barbies.
Standing in the center of the roundabout at Diamond is a giant anteater, which according to President Ali represents strength, resilience, and courage, qualities that were imbued in all the victims of the crash. Beneath the anteater, an inscription featuring the names of the fallen soldiers is displayed. A steel structure has been erected at Great Diamond Roundabout, where their names are placed, while another will be placed at the Eccles Roundabout. The Heroes Highway, constructed at a cost of approximately $13.3 billion, spans 9.4 kilometers and features over 30 reinforced concrete bridges and 2 roundabouts. The first phase of the 4-lane road from Mandela Avenue to Eccles Road was commissioned last year at a cost of approximately $2.6 billion. Additionally, contracts totaling over $11 billion have already been awarded to advance the thoroughfare from Diamond to Busby Dam Craig. The road is expected to extend beyond Busby Dam Craig, ultimately reaching the Suzite Linden Highway. Trishelle Sobers, Evening News.
President Dr. Irfan Ali has assured that all relevant stakeholders were consulted before he agreed to a regionally brokered meeting between himself and Venezuelan President Nicolas Maduro. According to the head of state, this includes legal experts, diplomats, and opposition leader Aubrey Norton. Here is Trishelle Sobers again with the details.
President Dr. Irfan Ali gave this assurance in an address to the nation on Sunday, during which he explained that the reasoning behind agreeing to meet with Venezuelan President Nicolas Maduro in St. Vincent and the Grenadines on December 14 with the aim of de-escalating the hostilities with which Venezuela has been threatening Guyana's territory. According to President Ali, all stakeholders were consulted before the offer by Prime Minister of St. Vincent and the Grenadines, Dr. Ralph Gonsalves, to meet with Maduro was accepted. President Ali says the condition of acceptance was that the border case before the International Court of Justice, ICJ, would be non-negotiable. In this regard, the head of state reaffirmed government's commitment to regionalism, peace, stability, and good neighboring relations.
Updating all of them on the development and having discussions around different ideas. After these consultations, meetings, I agreed that Guyana will participate and I will participate in a meeting on Thursday. In that meeting, we'll have a conversation with President Maduro. I've made it very clear that on the issue of the border controversy, Guyana's position is non-negotiable. That is, this is before the ICJ.
President Ali is optimistic that coming out of the meeting, good sense would prevail on the Venezuelan side and would result in commitment to peace and stability being made and removal of the threat to disrupt Guyana's exploration of its resources in its own territory. In the meantime, the president reinforced that Guyana will continue to push for investments and development of Guyana's resources in all corners of the country.
I assure all Guyanese, all our investors, our development in all 10 of our administrative regions, all 3 of our counties will continue unimpeded. Continue to push our investment, our investors, to work aggressively to bring prosperity to our country and by extension to our region. I want to also say that our collaboration and cooperation, social cooperation, developmental cooperation, and defense cooperation, our exchange, training exchange program, will continue as planned.
President Ali says the meeting is being supported by Caribbean community heads of government, noting that his counterparts in CARICOM has reaffirmed their support for the region remaining a zone of peace and for Guyana to resolve the border controversy at the ICJ. Trishelle Sobers, Evening News.
Making it clear that false expectations should not be encouraged ahead of talks between President Dr. Irvin Ali and his Venezuelan counterpart Nicolas Maduro, esteemed diplomat Sir Sridhar Ramphal also views the talks as a chance to preserve regional peace. Gerald Bryan tells us more.
President Dr. Irvin Ali has agreed to regionally broker talks with Venezuelan President Nicolas Maduro, who has in recent months intensified aggression against Guyana. Esteemed diplomat Sir Sridhar Ramphal, in a missive on Monday, reinforced that these talks could go a far way towards preserving regional peace. Ramphal lauded the role played by CARICOM in arranging the talks and noted that once they are approached in good faith by Maduro himself, then regional peace and security will be maintained. At the same time, Ramphal stressed that false expectations, particularly on the Venezuelan side, must not be encouraged. He noted that there must be no discussions on the Venezuelan controversy over the Essequibo region, which is currently sub judice before the International Court of Justice, ICJ. Ramphal reminded that President Ali only agreed to the discussions within the parameters of appropriate dialogue with Maduro. The senior diplomat, who is Guyana's co-agent in the case before ICJ, further urged Guyanese to support President Ali's efforts at securing peace. The decision to hold talks came about following an emergency meeting of CARICOM heads of government on Friday. Presidents Ali and Maduro will meet in St. Vincent and the Grenadines on December the 14th for talks that will focus on de-escalating tensions between Guyana and Venezuela. Gerald Bryan, The Evening News.
Do stay with us. More news ahead.
Electrical contractors, builders, and homeowners. When it comes to electricals, don't take chances. Invest in top quality electrical items from our electrical department at Gafoos. We stock brands from the USA, Canada, and the UK, such as Cooper Allied and Siemens. Get main and distribution circuit panels and breakers in various sizes. Electrical cables in sizes ranging from 1.5 millimeters to 16 millimeters in single core, flat, and ground flex. Surface and flush switches ranging from 1 gang to 6 gang. Also double pole switches from 20 amps to 45 amps. Outlets 13 amps to 20 amps, both surface and flush. Earth rods and clamps 6 inches to 10 inches. Also available are transformers, voltage regulators, and more. So for all your home and office and industrial electrical items, visit the Gafoos location nearest you at MacDoom, Parika, Nimes, Land of Canaan, Rose Hall, Beatty, Kanji.
Premier. Premier insurance coverage for less. Stay safe. On the job, you know how it goes. One minute, everything's going right, and the next, something goes wrong. Don't worry. Premier Insurance will make things right again. For all risks insurance, call 223-0840 or visit premierinsurance.gy. Fuel your success. Premier Insurance coverage for less.
Giving you the best Christmas with Digicel.
Digicel is bringing you the best deals, the best prices, and the best cash prizes. Hold on to your Santa hats, because there's up to $50 million in cash to be won. Activate any data plan, and you can be one of 14 winners to join Digicel's Spin to Win game show, where you can win millions in cash. Activate a data plan today on the best network, and make this Christmas the best one yet.
Shop at John Lewis Styles in December and win 4 Honda Navi motorcycles. Beat the traffic with this sporty, hip and fun bike to ride. Fully automatic with no gears. Just twist the throttle and go. Enter to win with every $5,000 you spend on men's and women's clothing, footwear, watches, fragrances, handbags, luggage, and now our home goods department. So visit us on Waterloo Street for a chance to win 4 Honda Navi motorcycles. John Lewis Styles. Simply different.
Welcome back. You're watching the evening news. Referencing the ongoing Venezuela border controversy, particularly the heightened aggression from the Spanish-speaking nation, the Private Sector Commission is urging the local business community to remain calm and resilient. In a statement today, the PSC urged the business community to continue their operations as usual. The Commission also encouraged business leaders and investors to maintain confidence in the strength of Guyana's economy. According to the PSC, by staying informed, calm, and focused on our daily activities, Guyanese and other persons operating in the country can collectively contribute to the stability and prosperity of the nation. The salary increases announced for public servants this year, which stands at 6.5%, must not be viewed in isolation of the menu of initiatives which have supported Guyanese throughout the year, Public Service Minister Sonia Parag has outlined. Rupasina Rain tells us more.
In excess of 54,000 employees within the public sector stand to benefit from the 6.5% increase announced by government last week. As she delved into measures to raise the disposable income on Sunday, Public Service Minister Sonia Parag said it is an obligation of government to address the welfare of citizens. As a result, the increase for 2023 is part of a bigger picture in their agenda.
I think when you look at salary increases, you can't look at it in isolation as to everything else that has been forthcoming from government. And I've said this before, it's not a favor from the government. It is an obligation to take care of the welfare of the people. And it is just that when you give salary increases, it is a specific category of persons, but it must not be looked at or considered in isolation of all the other measures.
Among the menu of initiatives she outlined, which supports Guyanese families outside of increased wages, is the Because We Care cash grant, the robust housing program, one-off grants for public servants, and salary adjustments for the disciplined forces and healthcare workers. This year, salary adjustments and allowances were also announced for graduate teachers. Meanwhile, the Public Service Minister also addressed statements from Leader of the Opposition Aubrey Norton castigating the one-off bonus for disciplined services.
When you look at 2015 to 2020, that administration completely removed, so you had 0%, zero bonus to the joint services. So how can you now come and ridicule the government for giving not only a salary increase, not only a one-off of 25,000 in 2023, but also the bonus that is given to the joint services, restored and continuously be given every year? You are making statements that I consider to be ridiculously bold and very, very untruthful.
Finance Minister Dr. Ashni Singh had outlined when he made the announcement that the consequential salary adjustments will place an additional $7.5 billion in disposable income annually in the hands of these employees. Rupa Sinarayan, The Evening News.
A laborer was today remanded to prison for allegedly stabbing a man to death over a $5,000 bet. Our Burbies correspondent Andrew Carmichael has the details.
Following the demise of 45-year-old Kern Wilson some 13 days after he was stabbed, the accused, who had been released on bail, returned to court on Monday, where he was slapped with a murder charge. 27-year-old Mortimer Sandy, a laborer of Glasgow New Housing Scheme, New Amsterdam Burbies, appeared before Peter Yu at the New Amsterdam Magistrates Court, where he was not required to plead to the charge, which states that on December 6th, he murdered Wilson. Sandy is being represented by attorney-at-law Tuana Hardy, who told the court that the accused was initially charged with attempted murder, but with the passing of Wilson, a new charge was being instituted. The prosecution told the court that the police are awaiting on the autopsy report to complete the case filed. As such, the magistrate adjourned the matter until January 17th, when the police will be required to serve the accused with all statements they have on the matter. Sandy had made his first court appearance on November 28th and was remanded on a charge of attempted murder. However, when he returned to court on December 5th, he was granted bail in the sum of $250,000. In court on Monday, the magistrate noted that it was the third in recent times where he would have granted bail to someone accused of attempted murder and the victim would have died shortly after. Wilson, a father of three who had resided at Pepper Street, Heathburn Village, East Bank, Burbies, and had operated a bar and car wash, had been stabbed on November 24th at a shop which he operated at Edinburgh Village, East Bank, Burbies. The victim and the accused had a bet where $5,000 was at stake. Wilson reportedly won the bet. However, Sandy was reportedly not pleased and demanded to have his money refunded to him. He reportedly went into Wilson's bar and picked up the money box, which is said to have contained more than $5,000. This resulted in an altercation between the two men, during which Wilson was allegedly stabbed. He was subsequently hospitalized and remained in the intensive care unit of the New Amsterdam Hospital until his passing. For the Evening News, Andrew Carmichael.
Two persons died and nine others were injured when an overtaking minibus crashed into a car and toppled several times before coming to a halt at the Friendship Public Road on Sunday. Dead are Keon Chandos Edwards, called Proctor Jr. and Mad Dog, of Lot 666 Kurukururu, Susaik Linden Highway, and Alvin Jones of Lot 4287 Tushen, East Bank, Essequibo. The injured passengers are 43-year-old Raul Porter, 69-year-old Bules Tang, 18-year-old Joshua Bacchus, 20-year-old Josiah Markin, 36-year-old Edward Tall, 29-year-old Mark Prechand, 22-year-old Karen Rodriguez, and 57-year-old Carlton Hodge. Additionally, another male passenger is in a non-conscious state at a Georgetown Public Hospital. The man who is yet to be identified is of East Indian descent. Police said at around 8:30 on Sunday, the minibus BYY7440 was traveling north on the western side of the road at a high speed. The driver, Edwards, attempted to overtake a line of traffic, swerving into the western lane and colliding with motor car PAD3102, driven by 36-year-old Jason Ramnott of Alliance Road to Mary, East Bank, Demerara. As a result of the impact of the collision, motor car PAD3102 collided into the rear of motor car PXX5169, resulting in further impact. The minibus lost control, toppled multiple times, and then halted on the western parapet facing west with extensive damages. Motor car PXX5169 was being driven by 45-year-old Kevin DeJong of Temeri, East Bank, Demerara. As the minibus toppled, passengers were thrown onto the roadway. Emergency medical technicians arrived on the scene shortly after, and the injured were transported to Diamond Hospital. Their conditions were listed as stable. However, the unidentified unconscious male was transferred to Georgetown Public Hospital in critical condition. The minibus driver, Keon Chandos Edwards, and passenger Alvin Jones were pronounced dead at the scene. A female prison officer has been arrested after she was busted trying to smuggle ganja into the New Amsterdam prison. The incident occurred at around 7:30 on December 9. The Guyana Police Force, in a statement, explained that the prison officer, as per protocol, was searched upon entering the compound. At the time, the prison officer was carrying a water bottle, which was searched. Inside the water bottle was a transparent taped package containing leaves, seeds, and stems suspected to be cannabis. Upon the discovery, the prison officer who conducted the search contacted her supervisor, and the further search was conducted on the suspect's vehicle in her presence. On the floor behind the driver's seat, a black plastic bag containing two transparent parcels wrapped with tape was found. As such, an examination was carried out on the parcels, and it was observed that a quantity of leaves, seeds, and stems suspected to be cannabis was found. The police were summoned, and the parcels of suspected marijuana were handed over, which, when weighed, amounted to 289 grams. The water bottle was also handed over to the police. The female prison officer was arrested and escorted to the Central Police Station. She remains in custody, assisting with the investigation. And now for a look at the bridge reports.
The Damara Harbour Bridge is scheduled to be closed to vehicular traffic on Tuesday, December 12, 2023 at 4 hours, for a period of 1.5 hours. Meanwhile, the Berbice River Bridge is expected to be closed at 15:50 on Tuesday, December 12, 2023, also for a period of 1.5 hours.
Marion Academy clinches MVP Sports U11 title, and Cropper Primary wins ExxonMobil Future Warriors Burpees Tournament. Details of these stories and more in the sportcast sponsored by MacCorp, coming up on the other side of the break.
Giving you the best Christmas with Digicel.
This Christmas, it's all about the best. Digicel is bringing you the best deals, the best prices, and the best cash prizes. Get half off and a whopping 50 gigs of data when you purchase the Samsung A04 for just $14,000, the Samsung A14 for just $29,000, or the Samsung A24 for just $35,000. That's right, half off and 50 gigs of data. It doesn't get any better than this. So why wait? This Christmas, buy nothing but the best. Offer good while stocks last.
Digicel.
As the festive season approaches, we at Sylvie's believe in the spirit of giving, and what better way to celebrate than with a Christmas promotion? Shop $20,000 and over for a chance to win one of three fabulous prizes: one smart 58-inch TV, one Frigidaire refrigerator, and a Yamaha 150 scooter. Drawings will be held on January 2nd, 2024. Offer valid for in-store and online purchases. Terms and conditions apply.
Looking to bring your dream home to reality? Or simply taking on a home improvement project? Then National Hardware Limited is where you should start. Let us put that touch to your home. Choose from over 1,000 Berger Paint Original Hues for any surface. We are known for our trusted brands such as Westinghouse, Philips, Sadco, Rubbermaid, Pyrex, Gibson Home, and so much more. National Hardware Limited, your do-it-best store. Located in downtown Georgetown and industrial site Rhymeville.
This Christmas, unwrap the thrill with Superbet. Spin into the season with our festive bets, where every wager sparkles with holiday jets. Visit a retailer near you or log on to www.superbet.gy. Season greetings from the management and staff of Superbet.